To continue quadratic motion and projectile notes, example number 4 says, given the following function, f of x equals x squared, answer the following. The first thing they say is, explain why this is a quadratic parent function. Well, when you talk about a parent function, it's going to be the simplest form of a given family of function. So f of x equals x squared is the simplest form of a given family function of a quadratics. Every single quadratic is gonna have that U shape. It might be wider U or skinnier U. It might be U upside down. It might be U facing up. It will be any kind of shape, but it will be a U. You know, anything like that, or you know, a mixing bowl. Those are all quadratic form, and they all have some sort of equation describe them, but they all come from a form of fx equals x squared or y equals x squared. So the next thing we're gonna talk about B is graph the following functions by starting with an input-output table. So we are going to put the x, fx on top, and that means every time you see an x, you're gonna replace with those number, and this is gonna be x squared. This is just -3 parentheses squared, and that's just 9. I'm going to fill out the table, and you guys can do the same. So here's the answer by completing the table, and I also plot the points. On to example number 5. Now example number 5 have a couple different questions now. It says, use the graph below to fill in the following blanks. A, explain how you can tell by looking at the graph that this graph represents a function. The reason you can represent a function is to do a vertical line testing and they only hitting one point. Letter A, explain how you can tell by looking at the graph that this graph represents a function. The graph passed the vertical line testing. So now the next A, B, and C is just picking out points from the graph. So the first thing you need to do is B is going to be looking at the equation f of 4. That means when x equals 4, that little number in here representing the x coordinates, that representing x. So if x is going to be f4, x 1, 2, 3, 4, right here, going up, that's 4, 3. So your answer will be 3. Just picking up the order pair, 4, 3. And if x is at 2, it's going to be 2, 5. And then when x is at the second part right here, that's the y. This is the y. That's the y. Okay. So in this case, looking at y is -3. 1, 2, 3. And then finding whatever the point is, it's going to be at -2. You need to know how to find those points on your graph. So that's the first thing. And the next one, you also, first thing. The first thing you need to do is find your, is that a function? Second thing is you need to know is locate all the different points. The third one is what are the coordinates for the y-intercept on this graph? The y-intercept on this graph is going to be thinking about x equals 0. When x equals 0, then what is y? That's what that means. So you can write it as f of 0. What does that equal to? All right. So let's take a look. If that is the case, I'm going to use a different color. F equals 0, which is right here in purple. Going up is gonna be at 3. F of x equals 0, the answer is 3. That is gonna be your y-intercept. Then f, it says, what is the coordinates of the vertex on this graph? Vertex is gonna be the highest point or the lowest point. And in this case, also is where the symmetry is. And that is your vertex. And in this case, they even give it to you. Vertex is at 2, 5. Then the next one is the vertex maximum, minimum. And because the vertex is the highest point for the parabola, it's going to be the maximum. And what is the equation for the x symmetry? Well, x symmetry is the first part of the x coordinate symmetry line. Let me put it in right in here in orange. So in this case, the symmetry will also be x equals 2. That could be the orange line, or you can pick it out as this one right here. That's also symmetry line. Don't forget the x. Is the same thing. When you do the problem, you explain how you can tell by looking at the table that this represents a function. Well, it's because x value was not used more than once. X value. Y value, we don't care. But x value was not used more than once. What you going to pick out the number for f of 4. Now, again, from before I told you that's representing what the x is. So What you have to do is you just going to go to find 4. And the answer for y, because fx represent y, that's going to be 3. And please fill out the c and the d and the rest of it, and then come back and check for your answer. So let's talk about, I think most of you guys can get c. D, if you look at 19, you get both the answer 6 and 0. All right. Then the next question says, so what is the coordinate of a y-intercept? And then I told you previously, y-intercept is when x equals 0. And when x equals 0, it's going to be in this one, x equals 0. So therefore, the y-intercept is 19. So 0, 19 will be the y-intercept. Then the next one, what are the coordinates of the vertex in this parabola? Vertex is the one that the y only shows up once. And then if you look at it, it's going to be in this box right here, that 3, 1 does not have a pair. All the other ones has a pair. If you look at it, 3 and 3 has the same thing. 9 and 9 has the same thing. 19 and 19 has the same thing. And the only point on this graph that does not have a pair is the vertex, because it only shows up once, all right? And so that in that case, the one that shows up once is 3, 1, so therefore that's your vertex. Then the next one, is the vertex a minimum or maximum or minimum? You can plot them. You can say, oh, 3, 1, 2, 3, do a quick sketch, and 1. And the next one is 2 and 3. Yeah, 2 and 3 is gonna give you up. So it's gonna be facing up. And then because it's facing up, is going to be the minimum points the tulip is facing up, or the rice bowl is facing up. So therefore, it's the minimum, that's where the lowest point is. And what is the equation for the x-symmetry? Well, x-symmetry is the first part, is the x-coordinate of the parabola. So it's the x-coordinate of the parabola, so there is your symmetry line. Or you can look at, because it shows up once, there's your symmetry line. The line of symmetry in a graph is where we can fold the graph in half and get a mirror image left to right. We can use two symmetry points to find the line of a symmetry of a quadratic function. And that's y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, where a cannot equal 0. So we're going to take a look at that situation. Example 7. Give the parabola, give the graph below. Use the fact that the graph has a vertex at 3, -1, and the point C is at 0, 8, and A is 1, 3 to fill the coordinate of point B, D, and line of symmetry. So what you're going to do is you're going to label what is your B, and your B is, I will believe, is going to be at, cutting it this in half, so it's going to be 5, 3. I'm going to put down 5, 3. And D is going to be 6, 8. And then the line of symmetry is going to be at x equals 3. All right? Then the next thing, that's all. Line of symmetry, why do I know it's going to be there? Well, it's because it's the lowest point. So it's going to be where the this is the lowest point, and then that's the x-coordinate. And because this is going to be 3, -1, this is your symmetry line. Going on to the next one. Example 8. Giving a function fx x squared minus 4x plus 7. Graph the following 6 symmetrical points. And then what is your x-symmetry line and u-symmetry line and so forth. So let's graph it. 0, -1, 12, -1, 12. I'm gonna plot them and I'll come back. By plotting those two points in -1 and 12 and 5 and 12, you would know that symmetry line is gonna go through between them exactly. So if you look at it, the symmetry line is gonna through right here, and that gives you 3 on 3 each side. So that symmetry line is gonna be x equals 2. Let's go back and fill it out. So B, x symmetry line is x equals 2. You know what? Let's use the same color when we do problem. Now, use the symmetry line to find the vertex. And I told you guys, to do that, you use the symmetry line, okay? And then you find, once you find the x, you plug in for your y. So you are going to use f of x that's equal to 2 from your x equals 2. Because that's your symmetry line, and then that's gonna be 2 squared minus 4 times 2 plus 7. And then what you're going to have, that's gonna be 4 minus 8 plus 7, and that's gonna be negative 4 plus 7, so that's gonna be 3. Your vertex is gonna be 2 comma 3. And then going on, what is the y-intercept? Well, y-intercept, you know, is going to be the C, which is, doesn't have any x. And because you don't have any x, that's going to be C is 0, 7. And don't forget, 0, 7 is what represents y-intercept. When you're looking for your y-intercept, your x equals 0. So you got to look for things that's x equals 0. And if you plug in x equals 0, this is going to be 0. That's going to be 0. And the only numbers that's going to be left is 7. So that's why x equals 7. So the, going on to E, what point is symmetrical with y-intercept? So let's plot them. So I'm going to plot y-intercept as 7. So now doing a different color, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So right here is 7. And because we are 2 space over from the symmetry line, then I am going to mark my x is the symmetrical. So in this case, it is going to be 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 4, 7 is the symmetrical point. So let's label it 4, 7. That's the symmetrical to the y-intercept. Then graph the parabola, label the vertex and axis of symmetry and any intersection. We know the symmetry line going down is in the middle. I know that y-intercept I plotted, so there's my blue color. And then I have a vertex, which is a 2, 3. My vertex is 2, 3, and that's 2, 3, and that's my vertex. And this is your y-intercept. Let's put the graph in, and that is your parabola. Please try example number 9 yourself. Number 9, the y-intercept is just a C. Find the axis of symmetry, you just put it in negative b over 2a, and then plug it in. I notice the fraction looks scary, so 5 over 2 is really 2.5. Punch it in the calculator, you get negative 11.75. Does the graph go opens up or down? Well, since a is positive 3, therefore, because positive, therefore facing up. And I graphed it, and there is your graph, all right? Moving on to example number 10. Example 10 says, the revenue function for a company can be modeled with the equation Rx equal to 6x minus 0.02x squared. And the cost of function can be modeled with the equation C, R stands for revenue, C stands for cost, equals C of x equals 100 plus 2.4x, where x is the number of items made, and so each day and cost and the revenue are in dollars. Find the profit function. Okay, so A says find the profit function. Hint, profit equals revenue minus cost. So we are going to take Rx minus C of X, and to put the equation in, it's going to be 6x minus 0.02x squared minus parentheses 100 plus 2.4x. And when you distribute them, that function is going to be negative 0.02x squared plus 3.6x minus 100, because I just combine everything. If you guys notice, I distribute my negative sign, move them around, and combine them, and that's my new profit equation. Now, going on to the next thing, it says, find the coordinates of the vertex using the vertex formula. Again, that's negative b over 2a. And then find the vertex in this, what does it mean? And then D, if the company is currently produced 100, so we will hold on to that. But let's do B and C. You guys try it and then check your answer with me. So working through the problems, B says find the coordinates of the vertex using the vertex formula. So therefore, I use the negative B over 2A and I plug it in to find my vertex. And then I should have the vertex should be 9, -69.22. And what does that mean is when the company made 9 items, they are losing $69.22. So that's what vertex mean in this problem. The next, okay, C, what does the vertex mean in the context of this problem? It means the company made 9 items and lost $69.22. D, if the company is currently producing 100 items per day, should they increase production or decrease in production to maximize profit? Of course, if you do it by common sense, increase production definitely can increase some of the profitability, but I double check with the work and yes, it actually makes $60. So the conclusion is they should increase production to maximize the profit. And that will conclude the notes for today. And thank you so much for watching.